when I first read the Conjuring script, I was surprised that it wasn't just a normal horror film. It read like an adventure film as well. And of course, it had the courtroom drama in it. And the character that I'm lucky enough to play doesn't go through a conventional horror plot. So it was really a surprising script to read, and therefore rewarding, I guess. You want things to be surprising and to excite you and not be something that you've seen before, because then you'll just do a facsimile of that. So it was exciting for sure. Vera and Patrick have a palpable sense of loving working together. And I think that really translates on screen to a genuine warmth and connection between each other. And maybe that's something that's lacking from some horror films as well. I think when it's that immediate and easy, I think it's a different element, and it's something that people can connect with. And they're just fabulous, fabulous actors, and both in very different ways, and they both complement each other really, really well. Working with Michael on set has been great because the energy that he brings is phenomenal. Michael's the most positive director I've ever worked with. Nothing is a problem. Everything is an exciting challenge. Like even when we don't agree on something, we both come to a place of like genuine communion where something really interesting happens. So I've really, really enjoyed working with Michael. Yeah, when you play something that did actually happen, I'm sure there is a fundamental like bedrock of reality which you have to build the story on. So it helps not to doubt the intentions of the characters and the motivations, because you know they're real people. It also makes it a bit more risky that you have to respect that, you know, the real people were involved in this story and there was severely tragic circumstances around it. And that we'll never truly know what exactly happened. And yet, when we play it and we extract these elements from the story, we have to act as if we do have certainty. What I think the audiences haven't experienced, that they will experience in Conjuring 3, is the sense of the ticking clock and the race against time to save someone. It's a thriller, it's an investigative piece, it's almost like a detective noir. So I think it's definitely a departure from the haunted house, a thing that The Conjuring did so brilliantly in the first two. So yeah, working with Patrick and Vera was great when I got to do it, but I didn't get to do it all the time. My character, Arnie, he ends up in prison, so he's extricated from society and certainly the rest of the cast most of the time. But I did get a few scenes with them. And more of the memories I have of working with Patrick and Vera on the first day, really meeting everyone, and the first read through, Vera storms into the room, high-fiving everybody, Conjuring 3, baby. And I was like, this isn't the somber horror film that I'm expecting. There must be very serious actors about it. Patrick and Vera have a great rapport on screen and a great rapport off screen. They laugh and make each other joke all the time, and you have to. It's very dark material, and that's what I learned very quickly. So me and Sarah Catherine kind of had that relationship as well on set, showing each other stupid videos, trying to lighten it, because if you're always in that horrible emotional spot, which you're looking for, which is what you're aiming for, it's just going to become milky and hard to do, and you're going to exhaust yourself. So, you know, I try to be a little mini Ed and Lorraine with me and Sarah Catherine on set and take some cues off them. No spoilers. I am playing Arnie. So the story of the film, The Conjuring Devil Made Me Do It, is that Ed and Lorraine are helping the family of a boy who's possessed. That boy undergoes an exorcism and it fails. And instead, my character Arnie, who's the little boy's sister's boyfriend, he takes the demon into himself. He forces the demon to, he kind of riles him up to get into him. And then he ends up hurting someone. and he ends up going to the courts and going to prison. And all the while, he's still being haunted. He's still being possessed. And I think prison is probably pretty bad anyway. But he's going through an extra hard time. And it kind of gets worse from there until, you know, maybe someone comes and saves the day. But people have to watch it to find out. So this is based on a real life case. It's based on a true story. It grounds the story. It makes it feel real. I think it's a real benefit. I know James has said that as long as there's a grain of truth, then you can kind of embellish from there. But with the actual case itself, I'm not all that familiar because my character Arnie is kind of going through it at real time. You know, as much as I can learn about the case, it's kind of what happened in the court case after. And yeah, I know he went to prison and served 5 years or something like that, but I'm pretty vague on the details because mostly the character of Arnie doesn't quite know if he was the one who attacked this person, or if it was indeed a demon, or how culpable, even if it was, how culpable he was for inviting the demon into him and causing someone to really hurt. And these are really hard things to struggle with. So any kind of idea that I had about what might have happened in the case, I have no idea. I don't think anybody really does. It just would have gotten in the way. And I can definitely speculate now, but you know, I'd rather people go see the film and see what happens in the story as opposed to the real life. Yeah, so I'm new to this universe. Probably the last time I'll be in it as well, because that's just the way the story goes. I wish I could come back like Ed and Lorraine, you know? Maybe they'll take Arnie back. But Michael was new to the world as well, and it was so amazing how much he championed me because it felt, you know, he really wanted me for this role. I spent a long time auditioning. He really helped me out with direction and really put his neck on the line for me, which is incredible because he's totally new to this universe himself. And I think that really shows how important the film is to him. It's obviously, it must be scary. I don't know, I'm completely speculating, to come in and step into the shoes of James Wan and have James producing and Patrick and Vera so established in it. And from my point of view, he did a wonderful job. He made me feel so comfortable on set. He made me feel, he would, like at the end of a 12-hour day, he would still be clapping and calling out, yeah, after each take, you know, maybe not the very bad ones, but most of the time, his enthusiasm was palpable. And he was really brave in his filming decisions. He, you know, didn't shirk away and look to the producers what to do. He knew what he wanted to do and he tried stuff. And if stuff didn't work, he switched it out. I mean, he's just incredibly accomplished and showed a huge amount of acumen on set. And I just, even having seen the film like last week or the week before, I'm just even more impressed because certain things I was like, well, I'm not sure if that's the way I'd do it. Now I'm like, well, I'm glad I wasn't directing the film because he absolutely killed it, you know? I have loads of great memories from that time in my life. I was getting to know my co-star, Sarah Catherine, and we were both on this adventure of this huge film that we, on a scale we'd never done before at all. So it was lovely having a companion to go through that with. And we were doing acting exercises and trying out different things. So like, we're still friends today. That relationship is something I'll hopefully have for the rest of my life. That's a wonderful thing to have. And the memories on set, yeah, I mean, so much of it was me facing personal demons because I don't really believe in the occult. I've really tried. I was hoping every day that I would be haunted and then I'd suddenly have a newfound belief. But instead, I had to drudge up the fact that I was, you know, maybe I'll get sick with some terrible disease or, and really vividly imagine that. Maybe I'll never see my family again, that kind of thing. So that's a lot of my memories from on set. I'm like, oh, on that scene, I was thinking about, you know, my dad getting sucked out of the plane or something and going through the engine, you know? So, but they were great. I had so much fun doing it, conversely, because you have this permission to go to this dark, horrible place and come out the other side unscathed. And I think that's what people will get to do in this film when they go to see it. It's a thriller, it's a procedural, it is horror, it's all bedded in there, but it's really a roller coaster ride as far as I'm concerned. You know, once you're ticking up, you're like, why did I get onto this? But you're really happy once you did it.